Lung cancer can be quite difficult to diagnose because the symptoms of lung cancer are often vague and also attributable to other lung conditions or other conditions indeed. So if you do notice a difference in, say, your breathing, or you're feeling a little bit more breathless, or you're coughing more, or coughing for an extended period of time, for example, or you're feeling more fatigued than usual, it is really important to bring that to the attention of your doctor and have a good discussion with the doctor around that to see whether you require any further tests. A lot of the tests that help diagnose lung cancer are actually based around the symptoms you're experiencing. They range from things like blood tests to x-rays to CT scans. If the doctors are a little concerned, they may also look at things like a sputum test. They may send you to a specialist like a respiratory physician to look at having a bronchoscopy, where they actually have a look down inside your lungs. And through that bronchoscopy, they may be able to take a biopsy of something that they feel is a little suspicious. So it is a broad range of tests that can be done, starting with some tests that your GP can do, ranging on to tests that a specialist might need to do. Once you've had the tests, it's highly likely that your GP will get you back in to have a discussion around the results of those tests. Now, depending on the results of those tests, your GP will work out a plan for you, which might involve going to see a specialist to either have further tests or to confirm the diagnosis appropriately for you. Once you've received your diagnosis of lung cancer, one of the next steps is that the doctors will want to put a stage on your lung cancer. And the reason that they do that is because what stage you are will help direct what treatment options are available to you. So lung cancer has four stages: stage 1, 2, 3, and 4. And these stages are largely dependent on the size of the tumour, the amount of lymph nodes involved, if any, and also whether you have what they call metastases, or whether tumour has gone outside of the lung.